Welcome to Mastering Solutions. This is a motion on a ramp problem, and in this we have a soapbox derby where kids make these non-motorized cars and then they roll down a hill. They tell us that for the national championship, we have a 55 long section track and it's 13 degrees below the horizontal. So it's going down like that. And they say that the angle is 13 degrees like that. So this from here to here, we'll say is 55 feet. And then we have these little derby cars. That looks like a shoe. All right, so here's our little derby car. It's rolling down the hill. And for part A, we need to figure out what the maximum possible acceleration is of a car moving down the stretch of a track. So in the book, they give us the acceleration for an inclined plane equation, which is A is equal to G sine theta. It's really helpful to understand where this comes from. We know gravity always pulls straight down, so we can call that G. If we break this vector up into its X and Y components, let's do a tilted grid. So this inclined plane is the X, here is the Y. So this will be the Y component, and then right here is the X component. The only part of gravity that's pulling the car down the hill is this X component. The angle right here is the same angle as this. And in the previous two problems, we discussed why that is. And if we take the sine, or sine is equal to sine of the angle is equal to opposite over hypotenuse, we want to isolate the opposite or the X component of G. We have h, so we have opposite is equal to h sine theta. Now h in this case, for this triangle we just created, is g. So this times the sine of the angle right here, which is the same as the angle right here. Look at that, we just created that formula. So acceleration is equal to g, and it's positive or negative depending on which direction it's going. In this case, we're going in the positive x direction. So we'll use a positive g times the sine of the angle theta. So that's where this equation is coming from. Now let's plug in our values to that. So we have a positive 9.8 meters per second squared times the sine of the angle, which is 13 degrees. So we have 9.8 times the sine of the angle 13. Gives us 2.205, so we'll round that to 2.2 meters per second squared. So this is the maximum acceleration given this hill that we could get in one of these cars, and that is part A. Now for part B, they tell us that if a car starts from rest and undergoes this acceleration for the full 55 feet, what's the final speed? For this, we'll be using kinematic equations. We'll be using, for part B, V final squared is equal to velocity initial squared plus 2 times A times delta X. We're using this because we don't have any kind of time given at all. So this is the only kinematic equation that doesn't include time in it. We want to solve for the final velocity. The initial velocity for part B, they tell us it starts from rest. So this is 0. And we need to take the square root of both sides because we want V final isolated. So velocity final is equal to the square root of 2 times the acceleration times delta x. Now before we plug in our numbers here, the problem is that the delta x is given in feet and we need it in meters so that we'll get standard units out of the equation. So first we need to convert 55 feet to meters. We'll use dimensional analysis. We know we want the feet to cancel, so let's put feet down here. And in 1 foot, there is 12 inches. So now the feet will cancel. Let's go from inches to centimeters. And in 1 inch, there is 2.54 centimeters. Now inches are canceled. And in centimeters, for 1 meter, there is 100 centimeters. So now we're in meters. So if it's on the top, you multiply. If it's on the bottom, you divide. So we have 55 multiplied by 12 to put us in inches, multiplied by 2.54 to put us in centimeters, divided by 100 to put us finally in meters. So we have 16.8 8 meters. So the delta x will be 16.8 meters. So now the velocity final, we can plug it in here now. We have 2 times the acceleration, which we found is 2.2 meters per second squared, times the delta x, which we said is 16.8 meters. So we have the square root of 2 times 2.2 meters per second squared times 16.8 meters gives us a final velocity of 8.6. So 8.6 meters per second is the final speed that the kids will get at the very bottom of the hill.